Let's have some fun. This beat is sick. I want to take a ride on your disco stick. Hello?
Hello?
It's me. I thought I wasn't going to do this today, but my God, here I am. Here I am in all my glory, the queen of Eldritch Horror. Okay, Lady Gaga, later. Later. Later, Gaga. I still haven't had much sleep, but who can sleep? Who can sleep after such a weekend? My God, great Yaga, what a weekend I have had. At MythosCon. And it was certainly fabulous. MISKATONIC River Press. I'm going to write a book for them. Actually, I'll probably write more than one book for them because I was extremely impressed with Tom Lynch. He's a charming fellow, but most important, he has a lot of enthusiasm for his press and for publishing good books of Cthulhu Mythos fiction. He is dead serious about his press, and that's what I need from a publisher. I need them to be extremely committed to the genre and to their writers. And I felt that I just sensed that Tom is a fellow of conviction and commitment. I had a great time hanging out with him. I only bought one book. And I bought this primarily because I love the cover by Santiago Caruso. And I'm happy to report that my efforts at zombie hypnotism worked, and that Santiago will be illustrating the book that I am now preparing to write for MISKATONIC River Press. I have not actually looked at this yet. This is a gaming manual tied to the Call of Cthulhu gaming. It's got some great illustrations. When I first heard about the Call of Cthulhu gaming stuff, I was a real literary snob. I'm still a literary snob. I'm very, very serious about writing weird fiction. I like to keep my sense of fun. It's extremely fun to do it. But in my mind, if we are going to write fiction that is homage to H.P. Lovecraft, we really have to write fiction that is good and as original as possible. We don't just write fiction that rips off Lovecraft's ideas, his monsters, etc. So I believe it's also important. You know, Lovecraft wrote he was also very serious. Writing weird literature was his art form, and he was just as committed to the art of writing as some other writers, such as Henry James. Henry James was obsessed with the art of fiction. He even wrote an essay entitled "The Art of Fiction." I am also obsessed with the art of fiction. And usually when I write the word literature, I use a capital L. So I am extremely excited about the book that I am writing for Tom Lynch. and Miskatonic River Press. The first of many books I hope to write for Tom, because I could tell instantly that he is the kind of publisher that is a joy to work with, and that's what I need to make. You know, there are some publishers, they will remain nameless, who they are a pain in the ass, baby, and we just won't go there. You know, they sometimes it's not their fault. They run out of money, or they run out of steam, or things don't work. But it's nice to find publishers who are excited about your work, for one thing, and then committed to bringing it out in quality book form. So I am extremely excited about that. I'm also extremely excited about the publication of Some Unknown Gulf of Night, the book I just wrote last November. I wrote that for Larry Roberts, for his Arcane Wisdom Press. My buddy J.D. Worthington, who is a brilliant scholar, although he hasn't had much published, he has written some wonderful essays concerning Lovecraft at a forum called the Science Fiction Fantasy Chronicles. I think is a British site, but he has a keen intelligence and an original approach, and he writes wonderful essays on Lovecraft's poetry, which I love reading. So we got J.D. Worthington to write the introduction to Some Unknown Gulf of Night, and it is just a wonderful introduction. I'm so thankful for that. But what really excites me is we have Matthew Jaffe working as the artist for the book. Matthew did the cover painting for Laird Barron's Occultation, and the original painting of this cover was there in the art room at MythosCon, and to see that is just one of the most fabulous paintings I have ever seen. But to see the actual painting in the flesh, so to speak, that was just remarkable. And then Matthew hanged. We had a little discussion about this already, didn't we, Jerry? And I still can't remember. He hung. Another painting was unfinished, but he has a way of his style and medium and the color. It was just amazing. And so I am really, really excited because he will be illustrating, doing the jacket for my book, Some Unknown Gulf of Night. I am so excited about that. He also is doing art for this is another one of his work, for the Arthur Macken omnibus that will be published by Centipede Press. The new Centipede Press catalog was there. I got to meet Jared, and I'm so pleased with this catalog, because if I can find it, let's see. Oh yeah, there's the man. That's my favorite photo of H.P. Lovecraft. He looks so spectral there. If I can find it. Hey, where are you, love? Well, there we are. The Tangled Muse by Willem Pugmire. There's my book cover. The book has not yet been published. I was hoping it might be published this month, but Jared was kind of iffy about that. So, girlfriend, I don't know when that book's coming out, but that's kind of frustrating. But Jared is a genius when it comes to book design, and we had some problems with that book, and thus it became delayed, unfortunately. Otherwise it would have been published by now, but it will be out soon, so we beg your patience. So Dennis Etchison was one of the guests. I made my first professional sale to a book that Dennis edited called Cutting Edge. Where's Dennis's name? This was a story that I wrote with Jessica Salmonson called Pale Trembling Youth. I wrote it about this guy I was in love with, Todd Nelson, and it's set in Gasworks Park in Seattle. That was my first professional sale. I wrote the story originally for one of Jessica's little magazines, and she liked it, but she said it needs work, and so she reworked the story and she sold it to Dennis. Anyway, so Dennis brought me the paperback from Japan of The Cutting Edge. This is it. Pretty damn cool. So, man, I had a great time. I think the readings were sensational, but the most sensational reading was Michael Sisko. He read the story that he wrote for S.T. Joshi's Black Wings, but he didn't just read it. He performed it in the voice and personality of the narrators of the story, and it was the most chilling, spooky, mind-blowing readings I have ever witnessed. It was phenomenal. There were so many wonderful scholars there. Steve Maraconda gave a slideshow about the area that influenced Lovecraft's writing of The Color Out of Space, and it really opened up my eyes to the potential of writing about Arkham, because for the book I'm writing for Tom, it's all set in Lovecraft country: Arkham, Dunwich, Innsmouth, Kingsport, etc. Plus I'm going to write a new story about Sesqua Valley for the book. But Steve's wonderful slideshow about Arkham country really opened my eyes, because when I think of Arkham, I think of a city. I think of a city like Salem, but there's a whole lot of country as well. Delicious haunted country. So it really whetted my appetite to write a new story about Arkham. So I'm going to do that. I'm going to be a busy little Mythos writer, and that's great. So, alright, I'm still really tired, as you can tell, because I'm losing steam as I speak, but MythosCon was just amazing, and I'm hoping that Adam and Mark can do it again. The programming was the work of S.T. Joshi, and the programming was excellent. The panels were amazing. It was my dream convention, a convention about Lovecraft, and it was tremendous. So, all right, I'll see you all later. I need to start writing some books. Shalom.